Come on, man. Come on, dog. We're off.
Fourth straight week, Paladins will open in the eye at the 25-yard line near side hash going right to left. Tanner Scogan is the deep back, Marcus Anderson the fullback, and Tanner is going to take the pitch, throwing the option, complete to Andre Suttles, and this one is going to the house on the first play of the game. 75-yard flea flicker, and the Paladins strike just like that.
Bank.com. Here's the Furman Paladins. Reese Hannon under center, the sophomore out of Greer, South Carolina. Quick toss right side, but it's a pass coming down from Scogan, throwing downfield to Suttles. He makes the catch at the 40. Down the far sideline, he's in for the score. 75-yard touchdown on the first play of scrimmage, and Furman goes up 6-0, 14:49 to play. Furman making no bones about it. They have come today to play this football game. First play of scrimmage, Harvo. Quick toss, throw down the field. Suttles wide open. The redshirt freshman out of Dallas, Georgia. And in one play, 75 yards, it's a 6-0 Furman lead. And Ray early on to add one more.
Any yards that he could.
So third and four, this is a big third down conversion opportunity for the Paladins here. Hand him in the shotgun. Takes the snap, blitz is coming. Throwing over the middle, complete to Colbert, beats the tackle,
go.
Inside the 40,
he's gone.
30, this one's gonna go the distance, 10, 5, touchdown Ryan Colbert. Woo! He beat the coverage.
Or rather 46 of their very own, the Paladins put Hannon in a gun, shotgun snap, pressure coming, unloads, catch made at midfield, breaking a tackle. Down the field is Colbert, and he is loose inside the 20 to the 10 to the 5. He'll go in for the score, and Furman goes up 12-7 with 6 minutes remaining. 54-yard.
B, just the fourth Furman win ever in Statesboro. There's a second knee. 46 seconds on the game clock, so they'll have to do it one more time.
Well, you know, it's a heck of a way to go out. I'm sure the next time I
deserve a hard-earned 16-14 win.
Thank you very much. Very proud of our players and our coaching staff. You know, everybody was working, I mean, as hard as they could the whole game. And, you know, it's just a kind of an extension of what, you know, up to this point. You know, we just keep trying to find a way to win games. And I think, you know, we're learning to do that. I'm really proud of our guys.
And defensively able to hold Georgia Southern to less than 300 yards rushing. They really didn't have a big play rushing the football. And the defense able to come up with big plays when they need it, particularly with turnovers.
Yeah, we got some turnovers that were very timely. And, you know, Georgia Southern, to their credit, you know, they did a lot of things a little bit different than we've seen. They had a good plan. They've had some injuries at places just like we have, you know, and their plan was just to try to wear us down and pound us. And you know, we just hung in there and kept fighting. And, you know, just a great job of stopping them over and over again, whichever way we could. Turnovers, you know, just battling a missed field goal here or there. But, you know, just a little bit abandoned, but, you know, never really broke.